So next is principal focus of concave lens. So let us draw concave lens. This is the concave lens. Thin at the center in this. Okay. Thin at the center. Thick at the edges. This is concave lens. So this is the two concave lens will have two centers of curvature C1 and C2. This is the optical center. The imaginary line passing through the centers of curvature is called principal axis. So this is the principal axis. This imaginary line, the long imaginary line, is called what? The principal axis. So next, if the object is at infinity, if the object is at a object is very far away from the convex lens, the light rays will come how? Parallel to the principal axis. If the object is far away or infinity, at infinity, the rays will come parallel to the principal axis. Rays are parallel. So after refraction, they will diverge. We discussed that the concave lens are diverging lens. They will diverge the light rays. So concave lens will diverge the light rays. So when we are looking, these diverged light rays will not meet at any point. So when we are looking looking back in the direction opposed to the direction of refractors, when we are looking in this direction, we can say that they will appear to be coming from a single point. That point is called the principal focus of concave lens. So where this single point is situated, let us find. So when we are looking through this path, through this direction, the direction opposed to the direction of refractors. Okay, when we are looking in this direction, so opposed to the refractors, okay, they will appear to be coming from a single point. Where this single point is situated? How can you find this single point? So in order to find this single point, we have to draw back these rays. And we are also drawing back this ray also. So when we are drawing back these rays, refract rays, this lane meet at a single point. This point is the principal focus of concave lens. So how can we find the principal focus of concave lens? So when we are looking in the direction opposed to this refract rays, okay, they will appear to be coming. Appear to be means tonal. Appear to be coming from a single point. Appear to be coming from a single point. Where this single point is situated? So in order to find this single point, we have to draw back this refract rays. This is the refract ray. we have to draw back the refractor. This lay, this dot lay, when we are drawing back, this lay meet at a single point on the principal axis. So this is the principal focus of concave lens. So when we are looking through in the direction opposed to the ray, we will feel, they will be, we will perceive, they will appear to be coming from this point. ഈ റേസ് എല്ലാം വരുന്നത് എവിടുന്നാണെന്ന് തോന്നുന്നു നമുക്ക്? ഇവിടെ. സോ ദിസ് പോയിന്റ് ഇസ് കോൾഡ് പ്രിൻസിപ്പിൾ ഫോക്കസ് ഓഫ് കോൺകേവ് ലെൻസ്. സോ ഹൗ ക്യാൻ വി ഫൈൻഡ് പ്രിൻസിപ്പിൾ ഫോക്കസ് ഓഫ് കോൺകേവ് ലെൻസ്? വി ഹാവ് ടു ലുക്ക് ബാക്ക് ഇൻ ദ ഡയറക്ഷൻ ഓപ്പോസ് ടു ദാറ്റ് റിഫ്രാക്ടറി. സോ വി ക്യാൻ ഫൈൻഡ് വാട്ട് പ്രിൻസിപ്പിൾ ഫോക്കസ് ഓഫ് കോൺകേവ് ലെൻസ്. വി വിൽ ഫീൽ these rays will be appear to be coming from a single point. Where this single point is situated, in order to find this single point, we have to draw back this refractor. So when we are drawing back this refractor, these lens that we are drawn back, these lens will meet at a single point on the principal axis. So this is the principal focus of concave lens. So when the object is placed here, when we are placing the object here, so it is very far away from the concave lens. It is very far away from the concave lens. So the rays will come parallel to the principal axis. Parallel to the principal axis. After refraction, they will diverge. After refraction, they will diverge. So these refractors never intersect. So when we are looking back, in this experiment, when we are looking back, we will perceive, or they will be appear to be coming from a single point. Where this single point is situated, let us find. How can we find it? We have to draw back. We have to draw back. When we are drawing back, this lens will intersect at a single point. This is the principal focus of concave lens. So object is placed here, the principal focus will be here. Object is placed here, the principal focus will be here. So a lens, concave or convex, will have two principal focus. It is represented by F1, it is represented by F2. So a concave or convex will have two principal focuses. So if the light object is placed there, then light ray will come in this direction, and after refraction they will be diverged, they will not intersect. When we are looking back, we will perceive that this light rays are coming from this point. Okay, how can you find this point? We have to draw back. You have to draw back the refracted rays. When we are drawing back, they will meet. Drawing back the lens, the lens will meet at a point on the principal axis. This point is called the principal focus of concave lens. So, a concave lens or convex lens will have two principal focuses. Okay. This is the. So now, in case of convex lens, this is the principal focus, this is the center of curvature, so F1 and F2, see, okay. Suppose this is F1, this is F2. So in case of convex lens and concave lens, the principal focus is like this. So next we can discuss about the focal length. Next term is focal length. Principal focus we discussed. Next is focal length of convex lens and focal length of concave. Definitions same for both. So what is the definition of principal focus of concave lens?
So principal focus of concavalence, I am writing here. Principal focus of concavity. After that, we can discuss about the focal length. Okay. After that, we can discuss about the focal length. So, we can write what is focal length of principal focus of concavity. Principal focus of concavity. After that, we can discuss the focal length of the convex and concavity. So, principal focus of concavity. Principal focus of concave lens. Is the point on the principal axis. On the principal axis. Principal axis. Such that the rays that are falling on concave lens parallel to the principal axis. Parallel to the principal axis. Principal axis. After refraction. Rays are appeared to be coming from a single port. Single point and this point is called principal focus of concave. Principal focus of concave lens is the point on the principal axis. This point is situated at the principal axis such that the rays that are coming from infinity object on concave lens parallel and falling concave lens parallel to principal axis. Okay, after refraction the rays are perceived to be coming from Muktona, coming from a single point. This point is called what? Principal focus of concave lens. So this is the parallel rays. After refraction they are appear to be coming from a single point. This is the principal axis. They appear to be coming from single point. Ippudu na ee point nu vendaithe namukku thonum ee point, this point. So see, this point is called what? Principal focus of concave lens. Principal focus of concave lens. They are appear to be coming from this point. Actually they are not coming from this point. They are coming from what? The infinite object. These rays are coming from the distant object, infinite object. But we will perceive they are coming from this point. This point is called what?
principal focus of concave lens. So this is the definition of vertical focus or principal focus of concave lens. Next we can discuss about focal lengths. Focal length of convex and concave lens. First convex. Focal length of the convex lens. Focal length. So this is suppose the lens are coming in this direction. This is the center of curvature. Here also there is a center of curvature. Suppose later coming in this direction, then principal focus will be here. Okay. This is the optical center. O is the optical center. F is the principal focus. This distance, between optical center and principal focus is called what? Focal length. So focal length is the distance between optical center and principal focus is called what? Focal length. So this is the principal focus, this is the optical center. So distance between optical center and principal axis, optical center and the principal focus, distance between optical center and principal focus is the focal length. Distance between optical center and principal focus is called what? The focal length. Next is radius of curvature. So focal length is represented by letter small letter f. Small letter f. So what is focal length? Distance between optical center and principal focus. Distance between optical center and the principal focus, this length, is called what? The focal length. It is represented by letter small letter f. Next is radius of curvature. So this is f, this is c, radius of curvature. This is f and this is c. So radius of curvature is the distance between optical center and the water center of curvature. Optical center and the center of curvature. Optical center and the center of curvature. This distance or this distance, both are same. This distance or this distance, both distances are same. Optical center and center of curvature is the water radius of curvature. Okay. So distance between optical center and the center of curvature. This is the center of curvature. Optical center and the center of curvature is called what? The radius of curvature. Radius of curvature is represented by the letter R. So what is radius of curvature? Radius of curvature is the distance between optical center and the center of curvature. Optical center and the center of curvature. This represents by letter R. It is represented by letter R. So, what is the relation between? It is represented by optical radius of curvature is represented by letter R. Okay, relation between R and F. What is F? Focal length. What is R? Radius of curvature. Radius of curvature. So focal length is always equal to half of the radius. Half of the radius. This is the focal length. Focal length is always half of the radius. Suppose radius is, here radius, distance is what, 10 cm. So focal length will be 5 cm. Focal length will be 5 cm. Focal length is the half of the radius. Half of the radius. Suppose radius is what it is, C of the focal length will be 5C. Okay, focal length will be 5C. Or R is equal to, R is equal to what? 2F. This is 1F, this is 1. F is here what? 5C. So R is equal to 2F. This is 5cm and this is 5cm. So R is equal to 2F. So relation between R and F. F is equal to, F is the half of the radius. If the radius is 10cm, then F will be 5cm. If the radius is 20cm, then F will be 10cm. What? R is equal to 2F. 2 times F. So this is the relation between radius of curvature and the focal length. So radius of curvature is the distance between optical center and the center of curvature. Focal length is the distance between optical center and the principal focus. So so the terms related with the lengths finished now. So next we can start about the major formation.